the womb reenactment. Now this, as you can see in your handout, is for children ages 4 to 12 suggested. And this is to provide the opportunity for the mother and child to re-experience the womb environment and facilitate attunement and really teach a parent how to connect, listen, and understand a child's experience. And as we know, in adoption, the child coming through adoption was not developed in that parent's womb. So this is a way for the parent and child to have this bond that they didn't have. So it's really healing for a parent, especially those who've been through infertility, to go through this experience and really have that experience that they didn't get to have with that child, because they do want it and it's healing for both of them. So what I did was I thought, okay, how do I create a womb? A little play tent, one of these play hut tents, as you can see. As such, you can use a box, a large box. It doesn't have to be a play hut tent. You'll need a tube, which is going to be the umbilical cord. And you can get this as, does anyone recognize what this is? A dryer vent. You can get this for like $2 a yard. I think I paid $6 for this. And what I love about this is you can use it over and over and over. It's very durable. But you can use any form of tubing. It could be the inner tube of a wrapping paper. So it doesn't have to be this, because again, I want you to be able to not have to spend money for these materials and recycle. So you'll need a tube, a blanket. I have a parachute because it's such lightweight and it's easily breathable. Air comes in and out of it and I have a little hole on top. You can use a parachute, you can use a light blanket to cover, because what we want to do is not allow the child to see the parent or the parent to see the child. Because we want to have that experience of listening, connecting, attuning to that child's needs, because they'll be expressing what they want and need in here. So what I do is, as you know, with these interventions, if you're not excited, they're not going to get excited. So we want to entice the child. Guess what we're going to do today? We're going to pretend that you're growing in your mommy's belly, your foster mommy's belly, your adopted mom's belly, and especially those who didn't get this opportunity with that parent, because you didn't get this opportunity with this mommy. So we're going to pretend you're going to have it right here today. So the child goes in the tent. I put pillows, blankets. I make it nice and cushy for the child so they feel like, oh, yes, I want to go in there. I want to go in there. Then I tell them, and this is going to be your feeding tube. Like a baby has a feeding tube from the birth mommy to the baby. And you're going to hold on to that tube, and mom or dad, and I'm including dad. I've had moms and dads do this because dads don't have this experience either. And they enjoy it just the same. And it allows them to have a bonding experience with their unborn child. So the father and the mother are outside. They'll sit in a seat. They can be standing, listening. And what I direct the child is, mom and dad are going to send food down the tube, cookies, little finger cookies, grapes, M&Ms. I usually prepare the parent the week before. I go, bring all the favorite little finger foods that your child likes to the next session. Because I don't want it to come from me. I want it to be a nurturing experience and a familiarity between the parent and the child. So the parent is going to say things and talk to the child and ask questions. And go, oh, is my baby hungry? And I instruct the child, they can make sounds, they can move around to signify what it is they need. They can cry, they can even say words if they want to. So the parent can listen. I really encourage kids to make sounds, cry, laugh, kick the tent, shake it, And once we start, I have the parent attuning to how the child's communicating. The parent goes, oh, is that a yes? The child kicks it really hard. Is that a no? Kicks it really soft. So the parent is really connecting and listening to what that child needs. So I wish I had a child right now I could put in here so we could practice. This is so much fun. I love doing this exercise. I've done this with 13-year-olds, okay? Older kids, because again, remember, with children with attachment challenges, they aren't chronologically 13. They are emotionally, developmentally 3, 4, 5, 6, wherever it was where they regressed to, where their trauma was, which is where they are stuck developmentally. So we want to meet them where they are. So you might be surprised if you're thinking, okay, I have a 13-year-old, but they really act like a 5-year-old. They can do this. As long as you're excited and the parents are excited about it too. And treats always work. So we're sending food down the tube. The child's saying, yes, no. Is my baby thirsty? Oh, what does my baby need? And then I'll encourage the parent to sing a song. What would you sing to your baby? What? Have the parents sing, and they sing it through the tube. They say things through the tube. So the child's listening to the message being sent to them. It's really a nice experience for the parent and the child. And so we go through that. I don't do, you know, how many years ago was it when they did that, those rebirthing exercises? This is not about a rebirthing experience at all. And with pillows, no. This is about attunement. Teaching a parent how to listen, connect, read cues that they're hearing. I always follow the child's lead. If the child wants to come out, they can come out and we can pretend, oh, the baby's being born. The baby comes out and the parent and the child have this engaging dynamic. Oh, look it, let's count how many toes they have. Let's look at their beautiful skin. It is such a wonderful, warm, embracing experience because number one, again, the parent and child did not have this experience. And even children who were separated right at birth didn't have it with their birth mother. That attunement, that connection, that mirroring, that reflecting that they need on a daily basis. So I'm teaching the parent how to do that. Oh, is the baby crying? Is the baby upset? And what I've done is I'm, as you know, an attachment-informed therapist. So when I'm doing this work, I have bottles at my disposal that I say, would you like a bottle? And I'll buy like a $1, $2 bottle at the 99-cent store, and I'll ask the child if they want to have a bottle. You'll be surprised. The parent feeds the bottle to the child, a 13-year-old I did this with. We swaddled her when she was born, when she came out of the womb. I had water in the bottle, and she had this experience, and this was a child who was adopted at 11 years old. And she embraced it. She was able to do it, and it was such a wonderful experience for both of them. So I really love this intervention. And most children enjoy it. And again, it's the helping parents master the art of attunement, creating that mirroring, reflecting, attachment, bonding, the child attaching to the parent, and the parent bonding to the child. So I highly recommend the womb reenactment.